You can't even get a good scam going in this country anymore, and it's not even a scam. Ironically, what's happening, if you followed anything, is that people are trying to buy stock in a free market, and they're trying to buy companies like GameStop and AMC and Nokia. These are not companies that are under investigation, and they have pushed the prices of these stocks up, forcing all the hedge fund managers and hedge funds that have shorted these stocks to cover their bets, and they're not happy about it. So it's really these independent day traders versus, you know, the Goliath institutional big banks hedge fund people, and it's been unfolding for the last few days. One of the most interesting things in finance that has probably ever happened in history, and people are lining up on either side of it. Dave Portnoy and Elon Musk seem to be for this kind of, you know, disruption. And then you have people like Elizabeth Warren, who's a fraud, which we know, saying things like, casino-like swings in stock prices of GameStop reflect wild levels of speculation that don't help GameStop's workers or customers and could lead to market instability. What a word, market instability. Today, I told the SEC to explain what it's exactly doing to prevent market manipulation. So if you had any illusion that people like Elizabeth Warren wanted you to make any money, you now that illusion has been smashed permanently. They don't want you to make any money. Yeah. They don't care. They may want you vaccinated, but they don't want you to have any fucking money, okay? Elizabeth Warren does not want you to have money to better your life and the life of your family, okay? Remember everyone who is against this. Remember everybody that came out and said that this was egregious and it leads to market instability. And what it really is people trying to wrestle back a little bit of power, not even a lot, a tiny bit of power from these oligarchs, and they won't have it. They can't do it. They won't let you do it. GameStop gets to 400, they halt trading, right?
Yeah, they halt it.
Robinhood app, the guy stopped selling AMC. They stopped selling GameStop. And I'm into AMC, a little heavy. And, I didn't get into GameStop early enough. But this is the biggest disruption the market's seen in a very long time. And people like Elizabeth Warren are coming out and going, we know what's best for you. And what's best for you is that you make the money that we say you make. Right. We're fighting to get you another dollar an hour at your shitty slave wage job. Don't worry about it. We're trying to get you that. And we might get you a little fake health insurance, too. We might get you pretend insurance. How about that? You'll sleep easier with pretend insurance. But don't ever think you can get into the game with the big boys because they own us. It's absurd. And I, of course, have no illusions about I think people should hold these stocks if you can. Push, hold their feet to the fire. Keep doing that. And we're just going to keep seeing this. They're going to make it harder and harder. They'll introduce some new regulation. They'll say there's a certain net worth requirement to trade. Probably they're going to play around with all these things. I mean, you have hedge fund managers crying on CNBC. Right. Leon Cooperman's in tears on CNBC. Be like, I care. I care. That's why I'm upset. It's because I care. Do you care? Leon Cooperman. But yeah, I mean, and they keep bringing him on. He's like freaking out.
Yeah, he's always freaking out.
He's freaking out. This will end badly. For who? By the way, it's been ending badly for the American people every day for the last fucking 40 years. Now it might end badly for you and your friends. They don't want you in the Hamptons, folks. They don't want you at their country club. And then he goes, well, I voted for Biden. I voted my values over my pocketbook. Just want to make sure everybody knows that I voted for Biden. You know, it is really interesting to watch this all unfold. And these guys are coming out and they're crying. I mean, they're tearing up at the idea of this, at the thought of people exercising the freedom to buy securities on an app like Robinhood is making these people cry because they care about you. Remember that. You're making money and they're crying because they care about you. It would be like if you walked in with a winning scratch off and you won 30 grand and everyone you told started crying. You're going, this isn't the way it should work. What about the fundamentals?
What?
Well, what about necessary market functions?
Right. What?
They manipulate prices all the time. They inflate things. They short. They do everything. Okay? They care nothing about rules, laws. All they care about is winning and having more money than you. So when you start to fuck up their money, they get on CNBC and cry and say that this is bad for the system. It's not going to end badly. And just be honest about it. Tell people why it's not going to end badly. Tell people why it's going to end real bad. Just look at CNBC. Look at the host of CNBC and go, we'll do another 9/11. Straight up tell them, they go, we're prepared to go to full way. We'll release more pandemics. We're working with somebody right now, and we're going to do another. We're going to do a real coronavirus soon. It's going to be bad. Not that this one's not real, but they're like, we're going to do the plague. The next thing we're going to try is the plague.